And I really, really believe that I was born to be this eccentric, weird, aggressive person.
I mean, we love it.
What's up, guys? It's Tristan, and I'm doing it. I'm here. And yes, I'm just another bored guy during quarantine, but hey, I'm doing something, right? Welcome to my new project. Welcome to The Sky Is The Limit. I'm so excited that you guys are here today, and I'm so excited to actually show you guys what we have in store for you. So, what is The Sky's Limit, you may be asking yourself? Sky Is The Limit is a YouTube show that will be airing every single week. Hopefully, but no promises. You know it's a crazy world out there. Every single week featuring a different creator from around the world, guys. I am so stoked. When I mean creator, guys, I really mean anyone who is doing some type of creating. This could be a musician, a magician, an actor, a mountain climber. I want to see mountain climbers on here, guys. That'd be really cool. And we're going to be airing their videos on here, and then we're going to be doing an interview with them after so we get to know them, because that's what we're all about here at The Sky's Limit, is having some fun, sharing some art, and having somewhat of a community right now when we need it most, right? So guys, welcome to our show. It's ours, it's not just mine. Welcome to The Sky Is The Limit.
Don't change the world, the sky is the limit, and you'll go far, I'm sure.
Welcome back to The Sky Is The Limit. Hello. And we're very close to getting underway on our first creator of the week. But before we do that, let's introduce her to you guys. Guys, she was born in Germany. Moved to Spain, now lives in LA. I call her a world traveler. I think you should too. She's one of my friends from the American Academy of Dramatic Arts. She's quirky. She's fun. She is Maxine Rodiger. Roll that tape.
Way I'm low, gotta keep it down. Don't wait around for a signal now. Give me some verb, I ain't talking now. You wanna ride in the six, you wanna down in the six. But when I lean for the kiss, you said I'll probably send you some pics. Hell no, I want that cruel love. Body on my, losing all my innocence. Yeah, body on my, finding all my innocence. Yeah, body on my, losing all my innocence. Yeah, body on my.
Girl, why are you taking so long?
I forgot the wine.
All right, here we go, guys. The very best part, the part I'm excited to finally introduce you to my friend, Maxine. Here we go. Let's put on the Allstate headphones, I'll call them. Hello,
Maxine, welcome. Thank you for being the first guest of The Sky is the Limit. How are you today?
My day is going great, actually. Working on a couple things, couple projects, having fun with that. So yeah, awesome. Everything good.
Let's just jump right into it. How was Drama Jam started? How did this whole thing come about? Where was the inspiration? When did this start? The whole thing. I want to know everything about it.
So basically, it all happened when we moved in together, the three of us, Justina, Alex, and me. And that's why it's called Drama Jam, because it's for Justina, Alex, and Max.
Okay.
Yeah, basically, one of my roommates, Justina, she was always looking for people she could do these kind of things with. And I did that when I was younger, just for fun, you know, like stupid little videos. We didn't even post them. But then actually we started having really weird and absurd ideas of videos we could do, like things people could relate to and laugh about. And it was just fun. We don't have that many followers or anything, but it's just so much fun putting out these videos and making people laugh. And the comments are so funny. And it's just, yeah, we film them in a couple minutes, then we edit them. And it's just hilarious to just do stupid things.
I love that they're just like, hey, let's just throw something together. Because, I mean, that's what it kind of should be, right? When you're just trying to entertain and just have some fun.
Yeah, for sure. It was just, you know, we don't really believe that this is going to be a big thing. But as long as a couple people laugh about it and we are having fun with it, creating those kind of videos, that's what it's about. You know, we're good with that. It's just funny.
What's the funniest thing that's happened, like, when you're about to film, or like behind the scenes that we haven't seen? Do you have like a funny story that, I don't know, that you can think of?
Well, actually, sometimes, for example, I don't know, the video where Justina is the DJ and I'm like the Coachella fan and like the Coachella person, you know, funny things that happen is that people see us and they're just like, you know, or when we feel, yeah, and you really have to get over it. You really just have to go for it. And I'm always like, okay, record quickly, do it. I don't want people to see me. And I'm like, 1, 2, 3. And then I dance and I do stuff. And then, you know, and then cut. And then I run back inside and take off my makeup. Or when we film things inside on the couch, it's hilarious when my dog, she has this judgy face. She's like, she just walks in frame and you're like, cut. So, yeah, things like that just go wrong, but it's hilarious. So sometimes we just put her in and zoom in on her face. So yeah.
Hey, that's great. Yeah. I mean, then you could kind of get that third character. Yeah. Isn't what they say, like, the animal's the best to watch on stage or something?
So funny.
What platforms can we watch Drama Jam on? If we're all going to go and we're going to watch Drama Jam after this, because we are, right? We're going to watch Drama Jam after this. Where are we going to watch it at?
Okay, so we are currently only on Instagram, and I think for now it's going to stay on that platform because it's the easiest way to find someone, you know?
And what is that Instagram for everyone out there? What's Instagram they can follow?
Yeah, it's just at Drama Jam. That's it. Super
perfect.
Easy.
Perfect. That's
super
easy. At Drama Jam, you better go follow it. All right, now let's just get into some personal stuff, Maxine.
Yes.
How is the, what do you do on this quarantine, like during weekends? What is your weekends looking like?
Because I work on weekends.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
What I'm currently working on is a project called You've Got Mail from a theater ensemble that I created.
Awesome. Yeah.
4 weeks ago. It's called the Artractive Ensemble. And it's going quite well. We're a big group of people, almost 30 people in it. And everyone kind of brings their ideas into it. And the project You've Got Mail is basically free online entertainment, podcasts or songs or children's stories, stuff like that. Just for people who are in need of happiness, a little hope and some entertainment, and they don't have access to it. Maybe they can't afford it. So we provide it for free.
That's so great. I love that. And I think I may be a part of that. I don't know, but I think I may be. Just a little bit. It's a great project. You better go check that one out too. I feel like a lot of the times of the videos I watch, you're playing these big eccentric characters, and it seems like you like those big eccentric characters. Yeah. Where did that stem from? Where was the beginning of the big eccentric character for Maxine?
Okay, so actually, good question, because I found, no, I got sent 3 pictures of a field trip we had in school, and I think it was, I was 14, 15 years old, and I never really remembered how I was during those times, but then my friend sent me those pictures just as a joke, right?
Yeah.
And I look at those pictures, and I'm literally the weirdo, and I'm like, people are in the picture, they're like posing like cool 13, 14, 15 year old people do, and I'm just, so people are posing there, and I'm literally like this. No joke. So embarrassing. But I was like, oh, okay, I've always been like that. I was born like this. And I really, really believe that I was born to be this eccentric, weird, aggressive person. I don't know.
I mean, we love it. And, okay, so what's the weirdest thing you've done in school?
So actually, I wasn't as confident as I am today. And you know me in school. I'm pretty outgoing. I try to be, you know.
But yeah, definitely.
In high school, I was actually, I was confident with my friends, but in public, in class, I was more shy. But what I actually really liked to do, and what was maybe weird to other people, was that when we had to present some work we did in class, you know, some presentations, I always used to act those things. For example, in literature, I wouldn't just make a PowerPoint presentation, I would actually act what the play or the book was about with my friends. And I wrote scripts, and I would make my friends do the weirdest shit. And yeah, one thing that was pretty weird that did not really have to do with school, I never published it, but after school, when I came home, I would actually, because I had this really old MacBook, yeah. So, you know, on iMovie, you can do those trailers, right? Hilarious.
Of course.
So what I... okay.
Oh, God. So what... oh, God. Here we go.
So what I used to do, and this is no joke, right? I really did this. I never uploaded it. I wish I did, because I would love to watch that on YouTube. I was 15 years old, and I would come home from school. I would sit in front... wow. I would sit in front of my laptop, I would turn on iMovie, select the trailer thing, and I would go to the bathroom and put on some makeup so that I would look like Hitler. And I was 15 years old. I went to a German school.
You were in Spain by this point though, right? You weren't in Germany anymore. Okay, no. Thank God. I mean, that's a little bit...
No, but... Tristan, believe me, I went to a German school. In that time, we were currently going through the history and everything in Germany from, what was it, 1939 to 45? Yeah, those times?
Yeah, of
no,
course.
Let me repeat that, because I'm German. It's 1933 to 1945. That's
okay. It. Okay, so, there we go. Correction, everyone. You heard it here first.
There you go. So, yeah, I would transform myself into Hitler, and I would play Hitler going on vacation, Hitler going on a date. I don't know why I was so inspired by playing this character, because it like, hands down, worst person in the world.
Yeah.
But, I don't know.
I mean, the fact that you didn't save them is ridiculous. I mean, if you could have saved these...
No. Worst part comes now.
Oh,
those videos are saved, but not on my laptop, because I forgot to delete them or transfer them onto my new laptop, and now my grandpa has it.
Oh my God, the grandpa has it! Wow, we're gonna do another video with your grandpa, and we're gonna try to find those videos. Oh my God, that's insane!
If I ever find them, I will send them to your show, and you will be the only show who can publish it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, beautiful. I mean, yes, them. I think we would love to see that. That sounds great. Oh my God. I guess you are a little bit of a weirdo. It's okay. I mean, this year we had Jojo Rabbit. You're basically like, you thought about Jojo Rabbit before it was released, right?
Yeah, you know,
somewhat.
People don't know it, but I'm actually the inspiration for it.
Let's do this question.
Okay.
All right. So you lived in Germany, yes. Spain,
yes.
And now are in Los Angeles.
Exactly.
Where's the best place? Where's the best place to live?
You know, it depends, because the lifestyle in Spain, where I grew up, I'm super thankful I grew up in Spain and not in Germany, because I appreciate the, the characteristics of Spanish people a lot. There is no judging. It's very, very loving, very warm, welcoming, and appreciative. And this is what describes Spain and Spanish people. And I was lucky enough to being able to grow up there and maybe also have those features now. To live for a person my age, our age, it's for sure Los Angeles. Because for someone like me who was born, there, grew up here, and now lives in LA, this is the perfect spot. Because what, maybe I'm not the only person who feels like this, but I felt my entire life like I don't belong here, I don't belong there. Yeah. Where the do I belong? No, you know? Sure. And when I came to LA, I met so many different people from different cultures, different countries, speaking different languages, different accents. Because I always thought my English accent is like, oh, you gotta work on this. But, you know, and then meeting all those different people, you suddenly feel like, you know what? We're all different. So suddenly we all belong here. You know? Great feeling. Yeah.
Yeah. No, that's awesome. That was a great answer. I was like, wow. I'm going to move to LA. Oh, wait, I've already have, but I had to go back because of quarantine. Yeah. Okay. Quarantine, watch yourself. Let's ask one of the final questions around.
Awesome.
What's one piece of advice you have for creators around the world right now that you think you can give them that can help them?
Okay, so I think there's only one advice that I could give that comes to my mind, and it's don't be stupid and put anything you have out there, because people can only see what you do if you actually show someone. And you can't, even if it's, you know, these type of people that always say, oh no, it's not ready yet. Oh no, it's not ready yet. Well, never mind. Just put out there what you have and try to create this this online platform. Even if it's just, if it's on Instagram and you put out what you just painted or a song you made, but do something. If you want to be seen, you have to make people see what you do. Like, actually put it out there and keep going and keep creating and don't stop. And there are good days and there are bad days. And I think it's the most important part is that on bad days, you work even harder, you know?
Yeah, definitely.
So that's my advice. Just do it. Just do it. That's a
great piece of advice. Yeah. No, definitely. I feel like, I feel like a lot of people, they like are like, oh, they think too much about it. It's like, put something out there that you love, and just the worst that will happen is your grandpa and mom watch it. They say they love it, and you move on and you get better from there.
Exactly.
No, I love that.
Yeah.
All right. Well, Maxine, thank you so much for being our first guest here today.
Thank you.
It was so much fun. It was great learning about Drama Jam. It was a great video. Yeah. I'm hoping more people go check out Drama Jam. But thank you so much for being our first guest here.
Thank you.
Is there anything, last words you want to say to everyone out there? Maybe projects you're working out, something you want to advertise?
Yeah, so guys, if you're an artist that is frustrated about what to do right now in quarantine, why don't you just check out the Artractive Ensemble on Instagram and get in touch with us and maybe participate in one of our pitch meetings on Saturdays and show us your ideas, and we'll be happy to have you, you know? So this is a project for everyone, not just those 30 people we are right now. This should be for everyone. And I hope people will actually get in touch and show us what they got.
All right, guys. Thank you, Maxine. Go check out the Artractive Ensemble. Go check out Drama Jam. Thank you for being here, Maxine.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you.
I love you too. Bye.
Bye. Hey guys,
do you want to be a part of this guy's limit? I know you do. I know you do. I know you do. So fill out the Google submissions and show us something creative, because I want to interview you. Come on. You know I do. And also, subscribe. I need it, baby. I need you, baby. Let's create a community. Let's have some fun. I want some baby back ribs. Sorry, that was just like me being me. Bye.